They see, like in these cases, they do once, they don't come anymore. You see, okay, I tell you one sutta. There's one sutta where a Brahmin came to see the Buddha. And this Brahmin told the Buddha, he said, "Lord, we Brahmins have a custom. When our relative passes away, we offer food. We offer food for them and we burn all the food. Will they get it?" He asked the Buddha. The Buddha said, "Whether they can get it or not depends on their rebirth. If they are reborn in heaven, they won't need it, isn't it? If they are reborn as human beings, they won't get it. If they are reborn as animals, they won't get it. If they are reborn in hell also, they won't get it. Only if they are born as ghosts, they can get it." Then this man asked the Buddha, he said, "What if my relative is not reborn as a ghost?" Then the Buddha said, "If this relative of yours is not reborn as a ghost, most likely you have other relatives in the ghost realm and they will get it." Then the Buddha said, "Even in the extreme case where you don't have any relative in the ghost realm, because you do this charity, you get the merit." So the Buddha did not explain why only ghosts can get. But I believe because only ghosts come back. If your relative is reborn as a dog, he might be fighting there with another dog. How to know you're doing? That's enough. Even like today, you are in this Buddhist society. Now you make a cup of coffee and you offer to your mother at home. Can your mother know that you're offering this cup of coffee? She doesn't know. How can she get to drink? She must know that you offer it to her and she must accept. Then only you can drink. Yeah? She can drink. So only ghosts come back. So you see, the Buddha mentioned that your relative can get it. So if it's not your relative, that ghost is not going to expect you to help. So he's not going to come to you. That ghost comes to you because he's a close relative or a close friend. So he expects you to help. So somebody asked me, "How come you transfer merit they can get?" That's an interesting question. Because this world actually is like a dream. Everything is mind-made. They have done experiments using hypnotism to put people to sleep. So if a person is asleep, and then in a state of deep sleep, then the doctor tells that person, "I'm going to take a piece of metal to touch your hand. And this metal, I'm going to burn it until it's red hot. I'm going to touch your hand." And then he takes a pencil and he touches this person's hand. But the hand gets burned. Because the mind, the power of the mind, he believes that it's a red hot metal touching his hand. You touch him with pencil, also it gets burned. It's not surprising because in your dream, I'm sure many of you will experience in your dream. Suppose in your dream, somebody punches you in the face. During the dream, actually, you feel the pain, isn't it? But nobody punched you, and yet in the dream, you actually felt a punch. Or stab you or anything like that. So the mind, the power of the mind.